Hello, I'm Bradley, and welcome to my channel. Something's been playing around in my mind for quite some time. Lots of things have brought me to a position where I try to learn from every event which has happened in my life, to be quite honest with you. This life has blessed me with many incredible things. Number one, an incredible family. I've been blessed with amazing parents. My dear Nan, who I sadly lost in May, it's been an absolute, it literally melts me how much of an inspiration she has been and an imprint she has been on my life. My parents, absolutely gift from God. Hearing loss, hernia operation after hernia operation after hernia operation. Then losing Nan, then spiraling into a real deep darkness. It all teaches us something. Striving for a really strong career, then the pandemic. All of these things, some of which some people would have already have gone through, some of which will last for a lifetime. When you love somebody so much and then you lose them, it turns your world upside down. It really, really does. My message when you click on this clip is, of course, enjoy today, for tomorrow isn't ours just yet. It's almost like a lesson, isn't it, really? And that phrase is something which means a lot to me. When I watched my nan in her last hours of her life, and I was with her and I was holding her hand alongside my mum and my brother, it really taught me that we spend our lives worrying about the smallest, most insignificant things, but at the time they are so significant. But yet actually, when it happens and it's our time, all of those things are so insignificant and mean actually very little at all. So I said to myself when I seen my nan leave this world the way she did, that I would take this through into life, that actually all the worrying in the world, all the stressing in the world, it means nothing, and we should not do it to ourselves. And it's so hard to do this every single day and to live by those words. But actually, when you think about it, when I actually seen, or when another person who's watching this, if you've seen a loved one deteriorate and pass away, or have been with them through every single element of an illness, and you think to yourself, what do we worry for? What are all of these feelings and emotions of stress and anger we have from day to day, sometimes about work, sometimes about needless things, when actually you think in the grand scheme of life, it means very, very little. And as long as we have our health and we have those we love and cherish and adore around us, then actually that's all what truly matters. Then it really actually does make us feel and tell us that those stresses and those worries are so insignificant. It's not something I think which you're ever going to find yourself at an end point. I think this is a learning, kind of almost like a constant sort of lesson throughout life. For me, why I've done this clip is because it's been something which I, and often people will know, my subscribers, my regular viewers, thank you very much from the bottom of my heart, that you will know that I often use my channel as almost like as a virtual diary to try and get things out. And often I connect with people, and often the comments and things I receive back are so inspiring and so helpful and so caring. It lifts me up, and it really does. It puts me back to where I want to be, and it helps me on the way. What I'm, and for me, which I should probably be honest about, is that the problem I'm going through and what's been really difficult this week is my hearing problems. And I've worn hearing aids for a very, very long time. I'm talking to you now without hearing aids, which is fine because it's just you and I. And I've had a hearing review this week, and I'm constantly in the back of my mind because in the last 6 months, my hearing has changed. I'll be honest, it's changed. I've struggled a little bit more, but I'm going to leave that for another clip, I think. But I'm constantly trying to read the future and what happens if things get worse? What happens if things deteriorate further? And that's something which stresses me out galore. It really, really does. But then I think to myself, do you know what? Take a step back, and I had an amazing, amazing lady at the local hospital who I've dealt with many times before, and she's really got me through the appointment actually on Wednesday, and it's that I should not try to keep reading the future. And I thought to myself, do you know what? That's exactly it. As easy as it is to say, and it's so difficult to actually do, but isn't it just that we should enjoy today, for tomorrow isn't ours just yet, and I don't mean in terms of death. I mean, yes, this life is so precious, and you've only got to turn on the TV to know that horrific things happen all the time in our YouTube community. The amount of young people which lose their lives is merely frightening. It's terrifying. And when you see that so many young people are going through illness and violence and all these horrific things, it is worrying, the world we live in. My nan used to say it's a crazy world we live in, my love. And you know what, now as I'm in my 20s, I really realize, I realize what my nan used to say. For me, my nan is a huge inspiration. My parents inspire me every single day. My hearing problems, my health problems, my endless hernia repair operations, which I've had. It all teaches me to say that actually, let's look at it at face value. From my nan. My nan was such a strong lady. Nothing would ever keep her down. Every day she would get up and go. Every single day. She'd walk into a room, glamorous as a film star. She was a star in my eyes. And she will always be. And she'd light up a room with, yes, how she looked, but also with her inspiring outlook on life that nothing would keep her down. She would keep going, she would raise her back, and she would face the world. Many of times, theoretically, with feelings of stress and worry, my nan has took my hand and we've took on the world and we've sorted problems out and we've sorted many of worries and fears out, just like what my mum and dad do now and carry on from my nan. That inspires me to think that actually, let's just enjoy today. Who knows what's happening tomorrow? Who cares what's happening tomorrow? Yeah, it's good to have a plan. It's good to have a plan for life and careers and aspirations and things. Of course it is. But in the moment of life and living, which is a little bit separate, we can all have those plans, can't we? But then in that separate thing of just living and getting through day by day, it's important to think that actually concentrate on the right now. Because if you don't, you can miss so many incredible and special things. You can, which are to be cherished and to be adored and loved and remembered for a lifetime. My hearing. I could sit here and worry my life away, still waiting for the future to happen. That's what I'm telling myself now. And actually, who knows if it's going to happen when I could enjoy today? I really could. It's like when I think back to my nan, I can sit here and think that actually, life's over. I've lost somebody so dear to me. Life's over. Or I could think to myself, well, actually, I'm going to get up. I'm going to seize the day. I'm going to enjoy this day. I'm going to make this day mine. I'm going to write this book how I want it to be read. Life, by the way, if you're not following. And I'm going to show Nan all I can be and all I can do, just how she would want. It's difficult. You can say these things, but what we think in here, in our head, is different. That's why I use my channel to be almost like a virtual diary to get these things out. If you can take away from what I'm getting at here, or this whole sort of subject and this phrase of enjoy today, for tomorrow isn't ours just yet. When you think of that, If you're not quite sure, turn the news on. You see all these horrific things happening around the world, and you think to yourself, actually, do you know what? That could have been me. That could have been, heaven forbid, that could have been my family. That could have been a loved one, a friend. Make today count. On the back of that, if you want to tell somebody something, if you think the world of somebody, whether that be a girlfriend, a boyfriend, a husband, a wife, a friend, a mum, a dad, a brother, a sister, an aunt, an uncle, a nan, a granddad, tell them. If you love somebody, if you think the world of somebody, tell them. Enjoy today. Do something spontaneous. If you're in a bit of a rut and you are one of those people, I am, by the way, who is striving for a strong career, who is studying away, who's trying to put every penny away for buying a house, who's trying to get up there in life. Sometimes that end goal absolutely is incredible. It really, really is. But the journey is just as special. Enjoy the day. Break that routine. Do something spontaneous. It could be something as simple as going for a cup of coffee with a friend, having a meal with mum and dad, doing something special, spending time with Nan. All wonderful memories I've actually got. Enjoy today, for tomorrow isn't ours just yet. Meaning, enjoy the right now. Enjoy the special time you've been gifted with right now. For tomorrow, it isn't ours just yet. We can't fast forward time. We can't reverse time. We don't know what's going to be thrown our way tomorrow. My faith gets me through a lot. It might not everybody. My family, my faith gets me through lots. Knowing that you've been gifted, for example, knowing that I've been gifted with the family I've been gifted, means everything. And that gives me my inspiration, that spur on every single day. Tomorrow, who knows what's going to happen? Why worry about it? As a brilliant song, which I think it's called Sparrows or something of that nature, and it's why worry, it's not going to add a minute to your life or something to that nature. And I often try to think of that in times of worry and stress. Today was a very, very busy day at work for me, and I worried and worried and worried about this important event which I was part of, and I was working hard to achieve. And actually, do you know what? It's gone, it's been done. And I thought to myself, do you know what? You've done all of that stressing and worrying, and actually, all your hard work was done. It was all in your notes. It was all in the work you've been doing for the last month. I worried, and now I feel a little bit silly and a little bit sort of, why did you do that to yourself? Again, enjoy today, for tomorrow isn't ours just yet. When you say it like that, doesn't it make perfect sense? Doesn't it make brilliant sense? I hope it does. I've really enjoyed doing this clip, and it's really helped me getting it out in the open and sort of getting this off my mind and sharing this with you. And that's what my channel's all about. It's not just always all about products and reviewing hair products and looking at hair and density of hair or talking about aspirations and goals and jobs and studying or skincare or holidays or everything like that, of what my channel is all about, by the way. It's all about, if I'm going through something on this bumpy journey of life, we're all on this together. Not just on my channel, think about it. We're all on that bumpy road of life. Nobody knows what's going to happen. Enjoy today. I'm not going to say it again. But if you do have any comments or questions, please see them down below. I have been through a fair few experiences in my life, and I'm only 28. So if I can help with anything, then I would be honoured and it would be a privilege. Please leave them down below, and I'll do my very, very best to get back to you as quickly as possible. Thanks very much for being here. Thank you very, very much for sharing this with me from my heart to yours. Thank you, and God bless. And I'll be seeing you hopefully real soon. Take great care, and I'll be seeing you then. Bye now.